Dear children, today we are discussing some important topics from the gravitation. In last lecture I told you force of gravitation and acceleration due to gravity. Dear children, in acceleration due to gravity, last result was g is equal to gm upon r square. This was the formula of acceleration due to gravity. When you see carefully, this was the setup on which we have calculated it. It is mass small m, and mass of the earth is capital M, and radius of the earth, suppose that is r. So we did value of acceleration due to gravity near to the surface of earth at this point particularly, that is gm upon r square. So dear children, one thing is very clear here, you have to note down this. Acceleration due to gravity is not depending upon the mass of the object. It is only depending upon the mass of the earth. Be careful about it. So I must write over here. Acceleration due to gravity. Is independent of. Independent of. Mass of the object. Mass of the object. To be careful about it. Okay? For example, there are two balls, dear children. One ball is made by the rubber. I'll take two balls. Okay, this is the one ball. And I'll take another ball, red ball. Okay, this is the red ball. One is blue ball, another is red ball. Red ball is made by the iron. That is made by the iron. And this is rubber ball, dear children. Both are falling from a certain height. Okay, which one has the greater acceleration due to gravity? As already we have mentioned here, acceleration due to gravity is independent of the mass of object. That's why both have the same acceleration due to gravity, rubber as well as iron. Be careful about it. Okay? It only depends upon the mass of the earth, not depending on the object around the earth. So this is the basic thing which you have to remember regarding the acceleration due to gravity. So dear children, today one more thing I want to discuss with you, that is free fall. Very interesting thing. Free fall. I must say free fall motion here. Free fall motion. An object is said to be free fall if it is supposed at falling freely under the action of gravity. Let's suppose that I'll take an object. This is the object, dear children. Suppose that I'm talking about this object. Okay. It is falling freely from a certain height. This is the height h. Towards the ground, and this is the ground. Okay? If air friction is neglected, dear children, air is absent, suppose that. And first thing. Second thing, it should be near to the surface of earth. Near to surface of earth. Surface of earth. It should be near to the surface of earth. These are the two things which you have to remember for the free fall motion. An object is said to be in free fall if air resistance is neglected and incident is happening near to the surface of earth, and earth is taken as flat surface here. Flat surface. If you go away from the earth, it doesn't appear flat surface, but for the free fall motion, we will assume it is a flat surface. Reason? Because we are just taking the consideration of object very close to the earth. Close to means 5 to 6 kilometer, 10 kilometer approximately, not more than that. Otherwise, gravity will increase. Okay, gravity will change. Okay, for your kind information, at the higher altitude, gravity will decrease. Even in the depth inside the earth, gravity will decrease. Okay, we learn this in the plus one standard. But here, what is the matter of fact? You have to remember this. That is, an object is said to be free fall is said to be free fall if its motion is only under the action of gravity. Under the action of gravity. And two or three important things which you have to remember while you're dealing with the free fall motion, that is, air resistance is neglected, dear children, always, and freely falling object is very close to the earth, and the earth is taken as a flat surface. These are the things. Then acceleration is replaced by acceleration due to gravity. Be careful about it. Okay. If you take the sign convention, dear children, here, for downward, always take the negative sign. For upward, you have to take the positive sign. You know, acceleration due to gravity is always towards the earth. That's why you can take it always negative. Be careful about it. Whatever situation you will be there, take g always negative in free fall motion. As acceleration is constant, we already know this, that is 9.8 meters per second square. This is constant value near to the surface of earth. Okay, if acceleration is constant, motion, free fall motion is called accelerated motion, uniformly accelerated motion, even I can say accelerated motion. If acceleration is constant, uniformly accelerated motion, we can call this type of motion uniform accelerated motion. It means acceleration is constant. Dear children, we did in the kinematics, I mean to say motion in one dimension. If acceleration is constant, uniformly accelerated motion is there, then equation of motion is always applied. First equation I must write here, v is equal to u plus gt, because acceleration is replaced by g. And second equation, if you take the height, displacement is height, then it will be what? Initial velocity into time plus half uniform acceleration into square of time. And third equation, dear children, that will be v square minus u square is equal to 2gh. So these are the equation you must apply while you're dealing with the free fall motion. What are the prior condition? I already explained. Air is absent here. It is taken near to the surface of earth. Okay. 100 meter to 500 and 5 kilometer till. And earth is assumed as a flat surface here. Okay. Let me tell some questions which you can understand through these conditions. First important thing is sign convention, dear children. Gravity is taken negative. Whatever thing you are taking downward direction, take negative, and upward direction, take positive. Simple, just like the mathematics. Now I'll take some questions. Suppose that this is a ball on the surface of earth. It is thrown with 20 meters per second. Okay. And the question is, find the maximum height attained by the ball. Attained by the ball. Attained by the ball. Attained by the ball. Okay. So how would you calculate the height, maximum height, dear children, when suppose that ball is reaching up to the maximum height h, its final velocity becomes zero. You know, acceleration is acting in downward direction continuously, and velocity in opposite direction, it is in upward direction. That's why it is decreasing continuously, and a stage will come at the highest point where final velocity becomes zero. And value of g we already know. For the calculation, even you can take 10 if it is required. But actually its value is 9.8 meters per second square. Now, which equation is appropriate to solve this question? Final velocity is given. Initial velocity is given. Height you want to calculate. Acceleration is given. Third equation, dear children, you can apply here. I must write here using v square minus u square is equal to 2gh. What is final velocity? That is zero. Initial velocity is 20. Square of 20, that will be 400. Is equal to 2 into 10, that will be 20h. okay, and h is equal to what? H also you can take positive here. Acceleration due to gravity is negative, that's why it will be negative here. Okay, so negative negative it become positive. So 20h is equal to 400 and h is equal to 20 meters. I mean to say, what is the physical meaning of this question? If you are throwing an object or a ball from the ground with some initial velocity, that is 20 meter per second, it will reach at the maximum height 20 meters. This is the matter of fact. Sometime, dear children, they will ask from you, be part of the question, find the time taken to reach the maximum height. Find time taken to reach maximum height. Find the time taken to reach maximum height. How do you calculate the time? Height is given, acceleration is given, velocity is given. You can apply any equation, dear children, first, second, and third. That I am applying first equation, v is equal to u plus gd. Final velocity is 0, initial velocity is 20, gravity is minus 10, and time is t. So I can write 10t, take one side, that will be 20, and time is equal to 2 seconds. This is called time of ascent. Time of ascent means object is going up. Okay, so be careful about it. This is the time, 2 seconds, when you throw the object with 20 meter per second up to the maximum height. Now, I'll take another illustration to understand the concept. Suppose that this is the ground and this is the height from which object is released. That this object is released from this point and this height is h. Okay, and they will ask from you, find final velocity to reach the ground. Reach the ground. Okay, and time taken also, time to reach. Both the things you need to remember here. Dear children, you know gravity is always acting downward direction. That's why downward direction we are taking negative, upward we are taking positive, sign convention. This is the origin from where we are counting the incident. All right. Initial velocity will be zero when something is released from a certain height. We want to calculate the final velocity over here. Acceleration is given, velocity is given, initial velocity is given, height is given. I can apply the third equation using v square minus u square is equal to 2gh. Final velocity I want to calculate, initial velocity is 0, 2g into h. What is the final velocity here, children? That is 2gh, and v is equal to root 2gh. Dear children, you can remember this formula. Whatever situation will be there, if object is released from a certain height, it will strike the ground with speed root 2gh. If you have a data, you just put the data h and g and you will get the final speed of it. Okay? If suppose that height is given 100 meters, just imagine height is given 100 meter. Just see from this point, these are the origins. Below this origin, things are negative. That's why h is negative and g is negative. So I can put here root of 2g, suppose that minus 10 I am taking. And h is suppose that 100, minus 100. Minus minus it become plus. That will be 2000 root. 2000 root means 10 root 20 meters per second. This is the final speed through which it is striking on the. By the same manner, dear children, some important fact you need to remember. If you are talking about the time here, this is a technique you have to remember. Suppose that ball is thrown up and it is coming back to the earth. For the upward motion, it is called time of ascent. For the downward motion, it is called time of descent. The time of ascent is always equivalent to time of descent, dear children. Be careful about it. For example, total time, time of flight, total time is called what? Total time of this object, total time of this journey is called time of flight. Okay. total time. If suppose that it is given 6 seconds, how much is the time of ascent? I must say that will be 3 seconds. And what is time of descent? That will be 3 seconds also. I mean to say, whatever time is taken by the object to move up, same time will be taken in downward direction. Reason? Because acceleration due to gravity is constant and the air friction is neglected from here. That's why. Okay, dear children? So by this concept, you can solve various problems, practice from NCERT or maybe other books. Okay, at least 5 or 6 problems you have to practice. At the end of chapter, I will tell some concepts as well as some questions along with illustration and assignment also. Next thing we need to remember here, that is difference between mass and weight. Difference between mass and weight. I'm drawing over here a table. Let's suppose that in one side I'll take the mass. Other side, I'll take the weight. Okay? The first difference, dear children, mass is the quantity of matter. Quantity of matter contained in the body. Quantity of matter. Suppose that I am talking about some material here. If I am talking about any material, just wait, I am talking about the ball. Okay, that this is the ball. Whatever material is contained in this ball, that is called mass of the ball. Okay, if you are talking about the weight, dear children, weight is the force acting on this ball, which will act always downward direction towards the earth. Okay, because it is falling towards the earth. It is falling due to the weight. That force is called gravitational force or simply weight. So weight is what? That is type of the force acting vertically downward direction. Acting vertically downward direction. Okay? So one is quantity of matter, another is a force. This is the first difference. Mass is a scalar quantity, dear children. Does not have any direction. Weight is a vector quantity. Because force has direction, it is acting downward direction. It is a vector. Second difference. Third difference, mass measures the inertia. Greater is the mass, measures the inertia. Greater is the mass, greater is the inertia. We did already this thing. Okay? Whereas weight is the force acting at the center of the body, which is called center of the gravity. Okay, I can write weight x at center of body. You can remember at least 3 difference. Fourth difference, mass is remains constant at every planet, but weight will vary. Why? Because gravity, weight is written by weight is equal to mg, dear children, only. How will you represent the weight? That is only mg. Okay? Mass is represented by the m. Its unit is kg and gram. And the unit of weight is newton and dyne, just like the force. Even sometime kgf, that is kilogram force, or gf, that is gram force. These are the units which will measure the weight. How will you measure the weight, dear children?
We need to remember to measure the weight. I'll show you. Just wait for a second. I'll show you the spring balance.
Right now it is not available. In next time, definitely in next lecture, I'll show you the spring balance, how it will work. Okay. But this is the difference between mass and weight, dear children. On every planet, mass is constant, but weight will vary because acceleration due to gravity is different in different planets. Just for your kind information, dear children, I want to tell you something very interesting. You know, Earth is an elliptical shape. If you remember it carefully, this is the ellipse. And this is called pole of the Earth, and this is called equator of the Earth. Okay? Radius of the pole is greater. Radius of the equator is more. Radius of the pole is less than the radius of equator. You know, acceleration due to gravity is inversely proportional to R square. More is the radius, less is the gravity. It means gravity at the equator is less than the gravity at the pole. Be careful about it. It means, what is weight, dear children? Weight is mg. It means you have the different weight at the pole and the equator. Only difference of the fractions, but difference is there. Okay, why? Because acceleration due to gravity is different at different locations of the Earth. Be careful about it. Okay, one more important fact, acceleration due to gravity of the moon. I must write here, acceleration due to gravity on the moon is 1/6 time of acceleration due to gravity on Earth. Be careful this fact. That's why weight on the moon, dear children, if you're talking about weight on the moon for object, that will be 1/6 time of weight on the Earth. So this fact also you have to remember. What is weight? You just multiply by m, it become mg on the moon and mg on the Earth. And finally, we can write weight on the moon, this formula you should remember, upon weight on the Earth is equivalent to 1/6 ratio. So this fact, dear children, you have to remember. Okay? And in future, dear children, in next lecture, I'll tell you thrust and pressure, fluid dynamics along with the Archimedes principle. Till that, revise all facts of the gravitation along with the NCRT. If you have any doubt, you can concern to me and directly make the contact to me. Okay? Till that, thank you very much, everybody. Thanks a lot.